name of the Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Tonight we pray the eve of Monday of the Holy Pascha week. And if we go to through the readings of tonight, we find that we prayed the 2 hours remained from the Sunday of Palm Sunday, which is 9th and 11th hour. And then we go for the eve of Monday of the Holy Pascha week. But we can stop here for the house of prayer, which our Lord Jesus Christ in the 9th hour after he entered into Jerusalem as a king, he had come into Jerusalem and all the city was moved saying, who is this? That's why the beginning, the key of the eve of the Monday, we find the following readings. Our Lord Jesus Christ, he was asking himself, who the people saying I am? Who am I? He was asking his disciples and continue to answer this question through the readings of the Monday Eve. Not only that, but it says that when he went into the temple of God and drove out all those who bought and sold in the temple and overturned the tables of the money exchangers and seats of those who sold the doves. So here he is asking also another question to be answered in the eve of the Monday. What is the house of prayer? What is the house? My house shall be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves, he said to them. So go out, I don't want you here. This is the answer of the Pharisees and scribes. They asked, they prayed him, we don't want you here. And it might be asked by our Lord Jesus Christ the same question to us, to each one of us. My house shall be called the house of prayer, but you have made a den of thieves. It could be the house of my heart. It could be my house of my life. And the same question, why, Lord, don't you accept the sinners? We answer him and say, we accept the sinners and thieves, and you sit with them and talk. Why in this time you said, go out of my temple? Why? Listen, they said to them, listen and repent. That's why he cleansed up the temple. He drove out all this because this is not the proper place which it should be. The same thing. You sanctified your body, sanctified by the holy Mairun. You became a holy temple. So it could be one day when God comes and say, go out from here, because you did not keep the sanctification and purification of your body and your soul and your mind. So you are not worthy for the kingdom of God. You are not worthy for the holy and heavenly Jerusalem. That's why you have to be ready. When we go through the readings of the Holy Week, you find that God is, and the readings is keep saying to us, watch. Watch yourself. Today, we heard early morning about the incidents happened in Egypt. People went to pray in the church, in Tanta, and at St. George Church. Others went to Alexandria. Thank God, the guy in Alexandria came late, or he came by the end of the church. But at least it happened, something at the gate of the church. But those people, they went to the church in Tanta. They were singing. They said that explosions happened during they were singing Eflogomenos. And particularly in the part with it, Hail, O Malik, Ayo Malik Israel, Osanna Malik Israel. It is the time it's happened on this. But God chose them because they might be ready at that time. They went, walked into the church like any one of us. Might some of them knew or not, some, of course, most of them, they did not know that this is the last time or the last hour of them. But they were ready. God looked to their heart and they counted them among the martyrs. He said to them, I don't want you to celebrate, to enter with me to into the earthly Jerusalem, but I will take you with a Palm Sunday holding in your hands to celebrate with me the heavenly Jerusalem. So our Lord Jesus Christ came at that time for these particular people, did not say to them, go out from my temple. He did not drive out them out of the church, but he joined and take them with him to celebrate the heavenly Jerusalem. So here, there is a question tonight for us. Why did you come here today? Why did you come to the church today? Did you ask your question that? Or even in Sunday or any day of the, why you come to the church? Why did you here? Why did you come here? And another question it should be, why are you coming so late? Right? One, God will ask some of us the same question. Why are coming to my house so late? الَّذِينَ يُبَكِّرُونَ إِلَيَّ يَجِدُونَنِي. Those who comes to me early will find me. الَّذِينَ يُبَكِّرُونَ إِلَيَّ يَجِدُونَنِي. Another question might be asked by our Lord tonight. What shall I say? That you were not a priority in your life. God is not the priority in your life. Someone has priorities in his life. His priority is his work, his study, his friends, his family. And then God comes in second or third or fourth level in his life. He is not in the top of his priority. That's why our Lord today, he said to them, house of prayer. And we repeat that in litanies of the assemblies when we say house of prayers, house of purity. That's the, in the church, right? Biyut salah, biyut tahara. So always the prayers, it comes with purification or purity. Yes, you can have a defilement and we are unworthy to pray, but at the same time, you have to be purified to live in purity, in righteousness, in order that you live in and you keep the sanctification and purity of the Holy Spirit inside you. So here we say house of prayer. The Psalm 134, we say, bless the Lord, all your servants of the Lord, who by night stand in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord. Why we say that the house of the Lord? Because the house of the Lord presents the of the Lord in his house. You come to meet with Christ, but it could be your body is the place where the holy sanctuary. Your body, you become holy. Be holy because I am holy. He said that. So we have to be holy. It's a commandment. You have to live in purity. You have to live in righteousness. You have to be holy. Be holy because I am holy. This is a commandment. Our Lord Jesus asked Moses, our Lord had commanded Moses to build the tabernacle so that he will dwell in the midst of his people. So the column of cloud at the time, daytime, the column of fire at night, so they could see his glory. So if God asked Moses to sanctify a place which is on earth, how much your body it should be? If the earthly like that, when you enter a nice church, sometimes we go like here in the church and say, oh, how beautiful this building. If this beautiful for you on earth, how you should be beautiful in the sight of God. That's why today our Lord Jesus Christ entered into the temple and he drove out who bought and sold outside. Why bought and sold? Because this is not the right place to buy and sell inside the temple. And if we apply the same to our bodies. You may use your body in improper places to go or improper act or behave. So the same thing, it could be applied to ourselves. He will said, go out, you make my house a thief's den. جعلت بيتي بيت لصوص. يعني ربنا دشنك وكرسك وخلك تبعه في يوم المعمودية. لما انت تيجي تاخد الجسد ده وتعمل بيه الخطية, يبقى انت بتاخد بيته اللي هو جسدك اللي هو ساكن فيك وبتجعله مغارة للصوص. It's not only the Moses in the Old Testament, he saw the vision and the of presence of the Lord in his house, also Isaiah. In Isaiah chapter 6, it says that, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lifted up, and lifted up and train of his robe filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphim, each one had six wings. With two he covered his face, with two he covered his feet, and with two he flew, and one cried to another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And it's continued and said that its and posts of the door were shaken by the voice of him who cried out, and house filled with smoke. Then I said, woe is me, for I am destroyed, because I am a man of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the king, the Lord of hosts. You remember when he entered into Jerusalem, our Lord Jesus Christ, who was the people, they shouting and say, hail to you, the King of Israel. Hosanna, 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 which means he redeemed us. Khalasna, Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in Hebrew. But for this, they were cry and say to him, this him, he is the king. And he entered into the temple at that time. They supposed to see the real king, but they saw another side of Christ who cleansed up the temple. He drove us them, because this is not supposed to be in his place, in the house of God. The temple of Solomon and Zerubbabel, the same thing also applied. But here God wants to sanctify his people to be a holy temple for them. That's why we decorate our earthly places, like here in the church, with icons, saints, angels, incense, light, praises, hymns, and songs. All this, it's around us. But there is a benefits of respecting the house of the Lord. There is a respect benefits of this when you respect the God. When you respect somebody, it could be because you are fear or scared of him, so you respect him, or out of love, you respect him because you love this person, like the love for parents. We respect them because we love them. So, benefits of respecting the house of the Lord in our life, it will help you gain the fear of God in your life. So when you respect your body, your sanctuary, this you respect it, you offer respect to your body, to your vision, to your hearing, to your saying, so it will help you gain the fear of God in your life. So how do we gain the fear of God in our life? To respect your own body, not to lead it into sin. زي ما كده واحد من القديسين قال, لما الواحد يحترم جسده, يحترم نظره, بيبص في ايه, في كلامه, في سمعه, ده نوع من احترام بيت ربنا, لانك انت اصبحت هيكل لربنا وربنا ساكن فيه. So to feel his presence everywhere, not only in the church, and that will help you to easily avoid committing sin. When you feel the fear of God in your life, you feel that you cannot do that. I cannot go to this place. I cannot sit in this place. I cannot talk by this way. I cannot deal with this way. I cannot treat people with this way. This is, it's a kind of respecting the body and the house of God, which our bodies. As we also say that you will really take the blessing of his house, which is the icon of heaven and all the saints. That's why the saints of the church, when they respected their body under asceticism and under fasting, and they rule this under all this spiritual aspect, they could be a church or an icon for Christ in the world. So easily to find a humble person. Saint Anthony once, one of the saints, one of the his disciples, asked him, how can I see God? It was a short and easy answer. You can easily see God in a humble person. Because God was a humble. He is a humble person. He came, rode on a donkey. He was, when entered Jerusalem, he did not ride a horse or chariots like any other kings. He entered. That it was amazing for the people to see a king of Israel coming riding a donkey. They took off, what did they do? They took off their clothes, the garments, and they spread this on the ground to walk, the donkey walk in who is riding Christ. تخيلوا الدونكي ده الصبح كنت بفكر فيها يعني لو الدونكي ده I think he thought that the people spread the crosses on the ground for him not for Christ يعني الدونكي ده فرحان ان هم بيكرموه ففرشوا له هدومهم فبدأ rejoicing تخيلوا الدونكي بقى هيرجويس فهيعمل ايه يبدأ يجامب برجليه فهيعمل ايه في المسيح يوقعه من على ظهره واحنا بنعمل كده احيانا especially مثلا احنا البريستهود we feel that this honor it's for my person الكرامه دي جايه لي انا فبالتالي المسيح اللي ساكن جوايا بيبعد عني لان انا باخد الكرامه دي ليا الاونر the same thing happened يعني imagine كده ان الدونكي داخل كده وعمال يعمل كده فرحان بقى عمالين يحطوا له البرانشز بالم on the ground and he was rejoicing هيقلب المسيح من على ظهره لكن الدونكي كان ماشي ايه منحني عارف ان الكرامه دي honorable which was offered it was offering to Christ who was riding him not for us That's the rules of entering the church and staying in it. It's also the rules how to control your body. We say bow down before the altar when we enter the church. So you bow your body. You control your body. But as for me, عشان كده مثلا I give you something for whom they visited monastery. The monasteries in Egypt. I was last week in the Paramos monastery, and then I go out and in because my Allah is outside. So I go to the ancient monastery, Dir al-Adim. For Dir al-Adim, الباب عمل كده. فكنت أنا وسيدنا اللي ماشيين مع بعض سيدنا أطول مني شوية الأسقف والأب الأسقف الثاني. فكل شوية نوطي وإحنا داخلين. فالدير عايز يقول لنا إيه؟ كل ما تيجي تدخل الدير توطي. To bow your head. To bow your body, to control yourself, to rule your mind into the ground. Every time I enter, أعمل كده براسي. أجي أدخل الكنيسة أعمل نفس القصة. عشان كده ليه? This is the respect of the house of God. We apply to our sanctuary or our body. But as for me, I will come into your house in the multitude of your mercy. In fear of you, I will worship toward your holy temple. We offer also respect for his people, like the relics of saints, icons, and saints. We say in the church, don't talk. That's why you have to keep silent. You have to keep when you talk and when you keep silent in your body. also to apply it in your body. We say come early to the church because you have to offer you, if you are not consecrating, يعني نقول إيه مثلا الذين يبكرون إلى يجدون دي ممكن واحد يتكرس لربنا بدري ويكون شاب صغير أو واحد يدي وقت لربنا. عشان كده زي ما أنت ربنا بيقول لك تعالى بدري, come early to the church. Why you come early to the church? Because you need also to apply this for your own life. How do you be disciplined in your life? Not only in the spiritual life, spirituality only, but also in the other aspect of life. How do we discipline our life? Like wearing proper clothes in the church, we say all these things. Also, you have to control, you have to watch yourself outside like inside. I cannot say that when I walk into the church, I put a mask of the church. I show that I am holy. I show that I am a man of prayer. I show that a man of service, as a good servant. But outside, the people, they see the turn. The other side, pot and salt, treated. This is, it could be seen by the other people. He saw the changers, he saw, it's not the place of doing this. When you see a person, a Christian person outside, and then he is misbehave his life. He is acting like any other people of the world. Yes, today we are a Christian. We've been hurted by the incidents, but we are not fear. Don't fear of them. Yes, this is the work of Satan. God allows this to happen for us. But we have to show them the love of Christ. Even they hated us, even they killed us, even insulted us, I have to show them the other side. That the humbleness of Christ as he riding on a donkey and they enter today to Jerusalem. علشان كده مهم جدا ان احنا نسهر على خلاص انفسنا. النهارده ربنا دخل الهيكل وفي القراءات وتلاقوا بقيه قراءات ليله الاثنين من البصخه المقدسه المسيح عمال يسال تلاميذه يقول لهم من يقول الناس اني انا؟ قعدوا يجاوبوا يقولوا واحد بيقولوا احتمال تكون يوحنا المعمدان وإيليا. احنا بنعمل كده. ممكن واحد يجي يسألك هو المسيح بالنسبة لك ايه؟ يعني انا بصلي له المسيح لما بقى في ضيقة او بصلي له لما اكون تعبان, لكن مش كل يوم في علاقة شخصية بيني وبينه. تخيل انت واحد بيتصل بيك في التليفون لما يكون عايز منك حاجة. He calls you when he wants you. أول كده ما تلوك ينفون وتلاقي رقم وتقول إيه, أكيد فلان ده عايز حاجة. مع ربنا الفرق بقى. تخيل هو ربنا كده يشوفك جاي الكنيسة الصبح بدري يوم الحد, إيه في حاجة النهاردة؟ مش عادتك إنك تيجي إيرلي, يعني ليه جاي النهاردة بدري؟ ليه جاي ليالي البصخة كده ومنتظم؟ في حاجة أنت عايزها مني؟ هيجي يسألك كده السؤال, كنت عايز مني حاجة النهاردة؟ رغم ان ربنا ما بيتعاملش معانا زي ما احنا بنتعامل مع الاخرين, لكن برضو ربنا بيقبلنا. لكن لا تستهينوا بلطف الله. الله لطيف ورحيم وحبوب وركب على الجحش ابن أتان ودخل أورشليم, لكن لما دخل لقى الدنيا بايظة كده في الهيكل عملوا الصوت وطردهم. فزي ما الله هو رحيم ورؤوف ومتحنن, لكن لا تستهينوا بلطف ربنا. ممكن واحد يعيش في الخطية ويبعد عن ربنا ويقول خلاص يعني ربنا رؤوف ورحيم هيترأف هيجي قدامي. لا, النهاردة هو نظف الهيكل وقال لهم اطلعوا برا وقلب لهم الموائد بتاعتهم والترابيزات وخرجهم برا. اخرجوا, بيتي بيت الصلاة, جسدك هو جسد صلاة, جسد مقدس, وأنتم جعلتموه مغارة للصوص. يعني جمعت كل الحرامية. الحرامية دي بقى إيه؟ خطايا فكر, خطايا نظر, زنا, طمع, حسد, نميمة, جمعت كل الحرامية دي حطتها إيه في جسدك اللي هو هيكل الله الساكن فيك. فربنا يجي كده في اليوم الأخير يقولك إيه ده؟ ده أنت هيكلك ده جعلته هيكل للصوص، اذهبوا عني، أخرج برة. عشان كده كل مناسبة جلنا في أسبوع الألام وكل قراءة لها معنى. النهاردة يقول لهم كده، من يقول الناس إني أنا؟ طب أنتوا بتقولوا أنا مين؟ في الآخر ربنا هيسألك، ربنا موقفه في حياتك إيه؟ The place of God in your heart. إيه بالضبط؟ معلش يا رب، أنا يعني excuse me، I put my friend before you. I love him. I put my work before you. I put my family before you. I put my other business before you. Okay. So you don't have time for him. هو برضو هيجي يقول لك أنا ما عنديش وقت ليك. فيش مكان ليك. أنت حطيت حاجات قدامي. إمتى هتجيلي؟ إمتى هتتعبد ليا؟ إمتى هتقدس حياتك؟ إمتى هتقدس قلبك؟ إمتى هتقدس فكرك؟ إمتى هتقدس نظرك؟ إمتى هتقدس سمعك؟ إمتى هتقدس أعمالك؟ إمتى هتقدس حياتك؟ إمتى كل حياتك وكله يبقى عبارة عن حياة ربنا؟ دي مش معناه إن إحنا we leave our work, we leave our business and just consecrate. It's better to consecrate when you are ready and you're done with your study, but at least you sanctify and you make God priority in your life. You make him, you feel his holiness, be a holy because I am holy. There is no jurisdiction or something limited to the holiness. I can't say that the holiness is only in the church. The holiness is a life. To be a holy in the church, to be a holy in the street, to be a holy with my neighbor, to be holy with my friend, to holy with my colleague in work, to holy in everywhere. ليروا أعمالكم الصالحة فيمجدوا أباكم الذي في السماوات. To see your holiness there and to give glorify to your Father in the heaven, to whom is all the glory now and forever. Amen.